Hi Ethan, nice to see you. How are you finding life at Swansea City?
Yeah, I'm loving it. I think everyone can kind of tell that I'm loving it as well. I've been loving the games, I've been loving the lads, just the area in general, the fans. Yeah, long may it continue.
You seem like a man who's always got a smile on his face.
Yeah, I'm a happy guy. I mean, I'm kind of privileged. My job is my hobby, so I got a smile really.
And the team that you've joined are starting to show some really promising signs, aren't they?
Yeah, I said it from the start. Obviously, when I came, some of the lads were obviously thinking, oh, this is a new style of play. And then obviously it's a big change to what the lads have kind of been growing up to being like to play in. So I said from the off, like, just give it time, trust me. But then obviously they seen it from when they were playing on the pitch. So they realised that, okay, this is an enjoyable way of playing football. And when we get results, we smash teams. And it's slowly coming into tuition is the word, I think. But we're loving it. The lads are loving it. And I think you can see on the pitch.
Yeah, and I mean, 3 wins in the last 4, really good form. You go to one of the sides in the division who are doing well in Coventry, but you'll go there with confidence, won't you?
Of course. The manager is really fine on like details. So obviously we obviously beat Peterborough, but we always kind of depict like what went wrong, what was positive. And that's what we did today. And also for our next game, which is Coventry, we kind of like made sure everything was right for that game as well. So we're always looking ahead. Once one game's done, do what we need to do with that game, then run to the next. And hopefully we can show what we can do.
And on a personal note, how are you finding the Championship as a division?
Yeah, I mean, I think everyone kind of knows that I was with Russ with MK in League One. And obviously there has been a change from League One and Championship. I think it's more the speed of the game and the athleticism. In League One, you won't really get as many ball-playing teams. And also you're getting teams that are relegated from the Premier League who are basically another notch up when you're playing against teams like that. So it's great for me. Because obviously where I aspire to be in the future, is good for me.
What did you know when the loan move was being talked about and going through, what did Manchester United say to you, Ethan, about coming to Swansea?
Yeah, I mean, I had a couple options at first, and obviously they just talk to you like through it and like what would be best for you, and obviously it's your decision at the end of the day, so obviously they have to talk to you what they think, but then also it's what you think as well. But coming to Swansea was a no-brainer. Of course, the gaffer helped with that. But Swansea in itself being a big club. But yeah, familiar faces did it for me. It was just like, yeah, straight away. Because I know what I learned when I was at MK with Russ, like a lot of stuff. So if I could keep learning, I can only better myself. So, yeah.
Yeah, I mean, you're only a young man, but you've already had a taste of the first team at United, haven't you?
Yeah.
Did the manager there say anything to you in the summer about the way your career was going and perhaps coming down here?
I mean, it was kind of hard for me in the summer because the last game at MK, I got injured, did a bad one, which basically kept me out the whole of summer and the whole of pre-season. So I kind of, and because of the COVID situation, I wasn't really in touch with the first team and that. I was just doing my rehab. But then obviously I came back kind of like a couple of weeks before the August transfer window closed. So yeah, they spoke to me. Darren Fletch spoke to me. I spoke to the coaching staff, spoke to Ollie as well. They're just saying, listen, it's kind of been unfortunate for you because you haven't been able to show what you're capable of because of your injury, but now you have a chance to do it on the main stage. So that was really the talk really. And just, I know they're watching me, which is nice because sometimes you have this feeling like kind of like out of sight, out of mind. But they give me messages every now and then, so it's really nice to keep the communication. But yeah, they supported every act of it.
Yeah, some players at this club over the years who've been on loan, you speak to them and they don't really hear from their parent club the whole time.
Yeah.
They're away, but that's very much not the case with you and United, is it?
I think Man United did that on purpose because I think some of the players that are coaches now kind of may have been through that when they were a bit younger as well, so they understand that how important is like the communication bit of it, because you don't want to feel like you've just been left like they forgot about you. But yeah, that's it's tough for Man United. Can't ask for anything else.
So do you speak to people, Ethan? I mean, who would it be? I don't know. Is there a loan manager?
Yeah. So we have two loan managers, you can say, who watch our games every week, basically, and contact us like within the week at least twice, you know, analysing our game and just telling us what we can do better, what we did well, what we should look forward to next game. It's just giving us the best chance of bettering ourselves. And then we also have, obviously, the hires. For example, the first team staff will give you a message every now and then telling you, well done, or good luck for this game. I'll be watching. Just stuff like that. Just keep you in the loop, which is really nice, especially as a young player. So it's nice to have the likes of Darren Fletcher, Kieran McKenna, just being there for you kind of thing.
So they're watching Swansea then?
Yeah. Yes, they are.
And Russell Martin told us a few weeks ago, didn't he, that I think somebody from United had come along to training, had they here as well?
So. Yeah, yeah. One of the loan managers came to watch training and then obviously stayed up and watched the game. I can't remember which game it was, but yeah, the Swansea Man United had a little conversation, of course, for that to happen. And happy days, really.
Yeah, and it must be especially nice for you as someone who, I mean, you've been at United, haven't you, since you were a little kid?
Yeah, I think around 9, 8, 9, 10. Yeah, it's just nice just having someone there that's, obviously, the loan managers that are actually looking after us have been with us since we were young as well, so that helps. They've literally seen the whole growth. So yeah, I've been there since I was 9, and so were they, so we've always just gone up.
Obviously, the long-term target, I guess, is to get back there and become a regular in the Manchester United.
Of course, you know, as a young kid, I've always wanted to play for Manchester United. That's just something that I've always aspired to do. But you have to realise that there's steps that you have to take. Every person's journey is kind of different, and there's steps that you need to take to get to where you want to be. And I know that Swansea's a step that's going to put me in the right direction. So, yeah.
Are there players at United who've influenced you as well, Ethan?
Players. I mean, as a general, I think most of them do, as in how they act around the change room and whatnot. You get to see how they train. You're there with world-class players, really. So even when I was younger, when I'd get to like play up with the first team when I was really young, it's like you're just taking everything because you're literally playing with people who are world-class. They've won World Cups, they've won whatever, Champions Leagues, this and that. And that's what you want to do. So you obviously take it in. Try to soak up as much as possible. But yeah, in general, all of them, just it's just great to even just see what they do.
In the short term, of course, you're thinking about Swansea, and you've touched on it already. Russell Martin, clearly a head coach who you feel can help you in your career.
Oh, for sure, yeah. Me and Russ have to be honest, all the staff, we have a great relationship. I mean, I think it was important that I went to them year ago or so with MK, because it was kind of like a big thing for me, because at the time it was like, oh my gosh, going out on loan, that's like I'm leaving my parent club. I've never left my club before. Obviously they made it a lot easier, but then they also seen in me my potential, and then they've helped me get to a certain point of my potential, but I'm not at the end of it yet. So that's why I believe that being here, they can unlock even more of it. And I can see it. I think me and Russ have had a conversation saying what I was like at MK and what I'm like now. And at MK, I was good. But then Russ has said, listen, you keep improving and improving. But that's all you can ask for, really, as a player. You just want to improve and improve. So, yeah, Russ, the staff, I love them all, really. They have my best interests at heart. So.
And you've grown up as a right back, I think. Yeah. I don't know about any younger days. And then you played wing backs, starting with MK Dons, I think.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
From what we've seen of you, I mean, you play more like a winger. I mean, have you played further forward in younger days? How do you see your position?
Yeah, I mean, it's a hard one, because when you're young, you just play football, don't you? They just put you wherever they think you can play, kind of thing, and it kind of mixes around. But yeah, I mean, people say that quite a lot. I always play as a winger because obviously the way we play, we get the ball and we're always high up the pitch, and you need that 1v1 actions. And obviously, I can do it, and I just hope I keep getting better at it so I can be more of a threat. It's not that much of a change from right back, because when I was playing right back, I pretty much do the same thing, but obviously it's just you start a little bit deeper and you have a winger to help you, but you're just more isolated as a wing back, so you're really the only one on that side. And it's just a lot more long busting runs, like from there. With right back, you can kind of chill a little bit because you have a winger in front. I've loved the change. It's just showed that I can play both positions. I'm loving it.
And as a team, how far do you think this squad can go this season? Still relatively early in the year, and after a fairly slow start, things are picking up.
Yeah.
How do you see it?
I mean, first and foremost, for what Russ has done already, considering he hasn't even been here since pre-season to implement that style and that style of play, it can take a couple months to really get a hold of. And I think he's doing brilliant now. And I just know it's going to kick on even more. We're getting our results. I know the fans are loving it. But it's only just the start, which is the amazing thing. So once we really get stuff going, which we're hoping to do against Coventry as well, the sky's the limit, really. We just got to hope for the best.
And you mentioned earlier about leaving United and going away out on your own. I mean, are you down in Swansea on your own? How is life off the pitch?
Yeah, see, I'm a big sleeper, so I don't really mind being by myself. I literally get in from training and sleep, and then it's like, oh gosh, I need to eat. I deal with that fine, to be honest. Obviously, Swansea helped me with an apartment and whatnot, settled me in, and I know that the lads are there around the corner if I ever need anything, so it's been perfect, really.
And when you signed, you did that quite funny thing with the club where you were trying to learn how to say
yes.
Some local place names.
Yes.
How are you getting on with that?
It's harder than I thought. But listen, every day I'm trying to improve myself. So, yes, we are getting there, but we're not there yet.
Yeah. Mm. So, any Welsh words you've mastered?
Chileni. Yeah.
Pretty good.
Thank you.
Top stuff, Ethan. I just wanted to come back to some of the stuff that you said about the boss.
Yeah.
He described you as an old head on young shoulders when you first came here, which is quite a compliment considering, you know, you've not played that much senior football, or all of your senior football almost under him.
Yeah.
Do you agree with that quote, old head on young shoulders?
I don't know what to say about that, but Russ knows that I understand what he wants to get out of the team. And because I have that understanding, I think that's where he's getting that from. I just try to do I try to help as much as I can for the team, because obviously I've been through it before. I know the system, I know what works, what doesn't work, because even though I'm young, I've experienced the way we play. So I just try to give a helping hand whenever I can, really.
And on that summer as well, it was really disrupted here before you even came here. How was it for you? Because you say you were getting over an injury as well. It's not easy to move clubs, do all that, and when you're still trying to recover from what was, you know, quite a serious injury in some ways.
Yeah, it's hard, but you know, it's football, it's part of it, and you just gotta really just get your boots on. That's what you gotta think about, because you playing football is what you've been doing since you were young, and you just love it. So a lot of ruckus and whatnot, but at the end of the day, you're playing football, so you just want to get out there, and whatever's the best scenario for you to get out there, you go and do it.
And even from the very first day against Blackburn on the opening day, you could see that the style had changed massively.
Yeah.
But how much do you think you progressed from that game to what we saw on Saturday against
Blackburn? I think that's just noticeable as well. I mean, I remember I came down on the Sheffield game when we drew against Sheffield. I watched that game. And even then, it was a lot of keep ball. Obviously, we didn't have the final third stuff sorted, but we had a lot of keep ball. But now, you look at it, we're scoring goals and we're dominating teams, and teams aren't getting the ball. And that's the way Russ wants to play, and that's what we need to keep doing. It can be hard because, obviously, he's only been here, three months or so. And the way we play is kind of intense. It's a lot of sprints, it's a lot of short distance running to get the ball back so we can do what we do best. I feel like what we're doing already is really good, but we all know that there's another level we can reach, and that's what we're striving for.
And you talked about that Sheffield United game, I think it was the day before you signed. Did you bring your dad down as well?
Yeah, my dad was up. He just wanted to be there because he didn't really get to come the last time when I went on loan because COVID and whatnot. So he made sure he was there this time.
I think Russ has spoken about having chats with your dad as well, and he seems happy. You know, your family must be looking down, like trying to keep an eye on you because it's probably difficult then now that you moved away. But what do they feel about your move and how things are progressing for you in your career?
Yeah, my mum and dad, they have the protective eye over me, you know, because I'm a young lad. But Russ has made that a lot easier for them just to let go kind of thing because the way they treated me at MK, obviously, my dad couldn't really say much to them, obviously, because of the COVID stuff. But he really appreciated it. So when he came down and obviously spoke to the gaffer and whatnot, he really showed that. My mum is also protective as well, a bit more so than my dad. But obviously, Russ has made that a lot easier as well. So, yeah, they've kind of just threw me away kind of thing now. Happy days, really.
Yeah, and on a personal level, you've spoken about those chats you've had with the loan player managers and everybody else about, you know, improving, what you're doing well and whatnot. What do you think that you still need to work on and improve on it at this club?
Yeah, I have a lot of things. I mean, it's nice what I'm doing on the pitch and people will see and be like, wow, but I know where I want to get to. I know what I'm capable of. I don't really like to share what I want to work on and whatnot because I want to keep it within myself so I can just do it. But I just know that there's a lot of stuff I want to get better at, improve on, and even on my strengths, I want to make my strengths even stronger. That's me.
Just lastly for me, Ethan, on the fans, I think there's quite a good rapport with you and them already. We saw it particularly after the Cardiff game for varying reasons. we won't go into that one, but how, you know, you clearly love down here. I think it's the style and the way and your confidence and swagger, I think that really shows. Would you agree with that?
Yeah, I just play the way I am. The way I am off the pitch, I'm on the pitch. That's the only way I can really explain it. I just play with the confidence I have, and that's the best way, I think, because you're comfortable within yourself. You're just doing what you do best. So
top man. Thanks, Ethan.
Thank you.